digital devices, and thus technology is also changing the classroom experience. In addition, tablet versus compact computer that allow you to write notes directly onto the screen with a special pen replace the graphic projector. With the table to technology allow professor to make notes on charts and spreadsheet and send them directly to their students' PC. And in this way, technology becomes blissful, especially for English language learners. Thank you.
Thank you, Naina ma'am. Now I would like to request Namrata Gohil ma'am for presenting a paper titled Identification. Yes, ma'am, are you there? Next, I would
yes, Kavisha. Hello, Kavisha.
Okay. Namra Rizvi, ma'am, please be ready with your presentation. Yes, ma'am, you can start.
Yes, thank you, Kavisha. Now I am sharing my screen. Can you see my okay?
No, ma'am, I can't see. It's not visible.
The process is going on. Hello, Kavisha. I think it will take some time.
Okay.
Can you see my screen?
Yes, ma'am, it's visible. Can you please turn on the tab of PowerPoint presentation?
Okay, thank you, Kavisha. Yes. Can you see my presentation?
Yes, ma'am, we can see.
Hello, Kavisha, can you see my presentation?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, yes. Please put on.
Yes, thank you.
It's visible. Start the presentation.
Something about my to all that good afternoon to all of you, and my topic of paper presentation is identification of web tools for ELT to justify remote teaching for ELT to justify face to face and remote teaching learning process. But in present times, COVID-19 issues for distance by ELT for distance learning. The main concern of my paper is to discuss teaching strategies for.
Excuse me, Namrata ma'am. Excuse me. Sorry to interrupt you, but your voice is not hearable. Might network issue.
Not. Now. Voice is audible to you all?
Yes.
Hello?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Because my network is very slow and I am facing some network problems. Sorry for it. And it's through web tools in COVID-19. Here I am starting my presentation, and you can see my next slide. And in this slide, you can see these four are meanings of distance education. Through these all meanings, and here here you can see. It is play a vital role to understand the deep meaning that what is the distance, what is distance, the education. Here is a fourth meaning learning or locations away from location away from a classroom, building or site to another classroom, building or site by using or other predicate. Here you can see the essential criteria of education communication and locations. One main very important thing here has changed. Through this slide, we can understand that distance education needs a justification of two-way communication between teacher and students through different locations. And further, I want to say something that now we are living in pandemic time of COVID-19. So we give priority to technology. It's the best time. It is urgent teaching because the learners of English language are excited to learn the language through technology. English language learning in COVID-19 through stay home here of this group of learners. So we can say that distance education in COVID-19 lockdown feels as psychologically strong and it affects to the health of the learners. So distance education provides opportunities for more learner-centered instruction and allows students to explore, make mistakes and learn from their error. Leading students source of technology, relationship, distance due to a central cell, so they're committed to full for the processing of education. And here the distance tutor may use technology, for example, from interact and support students. And here you can see the chart that it shows the two way of communication between teacher and student while a distance education and while teaching learning. And here we can choose many web tools as a medium to transfer the content of teacher to the student, and a student can also send the feedback to the teacher.
Ma'am, you have two more minutes. You can continue, ma'am. You have two more minutes.
Okay, thank you. Here, you can see the types of distance learning. Here I open text time e-learning meeting, Google meeting and go to webinar meeting are included as a fixed time e-learning. And we can use it in our present time. And here you can see that what is synchronous and asynchronous learning. And you can see the all examples that included other asynchronous learning, and this information is very helpful to us. And here interaction between teacher and student is very important. Here you can see the state learner instructor interaction and learner to learner interaction is most important for social interaction. And so is for conducting teaching learning process chart of blended learning and that learning and this chart is very important to understand that what is blended learning. And here web conference fixed time of e-learning. Here I can say that web conferencing becomes the media for education field to continue its teaching learning process in each and every subject. For RWs to learners, for learning English language, for practicing their own way. For example, storyboard tool. For
ma'am, I request you to continue the presentation.
Poetry, right? Example. Okay. I will do it. You can see the examples of web and here are tools for creating instructional materials, and these tools are very helpful for teachers to providing materials to the students. Here you can see presentation school present presentation tools and acquiring software process. Here Bibly and Google Sites are a very famous example tools for collaboration. Here Wikispace is blog and learning process interesting with the collaboration of all in a group discussion. Tools for sharing resources. Here it is Pinterest and Pulitzer. It is also a very useful tool to share resources. And here I include my topic. And I conclude my presentation with this beautiful line that learner to develop passion for computers and technology to survive in the present time. Thank you, Kavisha.
Thank you, ma'am. Now I would like to request Namra Rizvi ma'am to present her paper, and Meera Patel, sir, please be ready for the next presentation of yours.
Hello Kavisha, am I audible?
Yes, ma'am, precisely.
Okay. Good afternoon, one and all. I am Namra Rizvi from Karamat Hussain Muslim Girls PG College, affiliated to University of Lucknow. Today, I am going to present a case study of practical aspects of English learning and teaching and technology. The application of modern technology represents a significant advance in contemporary English language teaching. Most upgraded English language teachers now actively incorporate a range of a technical aid designed to facilitate optimum teaching delivery. Due to coronavirus and pandemic, and this pandemic, these aids and technologies are on the front foot for delivering the best possible knowledge. Many online portals and links are created so that the learners can join and keep in touch with the syllabus even in the hard time of lockdown. The current research therefore addresses various elements of technologies used in English teaching by designing innovative curricula which harness recent specific and technical development. Here I remember a piece of Urdu poetry which somehow is connected with the present scenario. Kagaz ki mehak ye nasha rootne ko hai, ye aakhri sadi hai, kitabon se ishq ki. As a simple gadget cannot replace a teacher, they can finish the syllabus, but what about culture and manner? The use of modern technology in English language teaching is broadly understood to encompass an innovative application of methods, tools, and materials, which are directly relevant to English language teaching and led to the desired goal. As in current scenario, it is needful for universities and colleges to focus majorly on the use of technology. Technology in the field of English language teaching will provide a break for students from traditional classroom methods. It is highly effective in engaging students with a new innovative teaching style that enriches their understanding. The technological advancement provides simultaneous-based teaching that promotes efficiency in the overall teaching and learning process. Students are more enthusiastic and interactive while using modern technologies to absorb English and more than 90%. This process perhaps can fully enrich students' thinking and practical language skills and promote improved efficiency in overall teaching and learning. Here I want to quote R. Buckminster. If you want to teach people a new way of thinking, don't bother try to teach them. Instead, give them a tool, the use of which will lead to a new way of thinking and learning as well. Here, I want to unquote this. The study confirms that the use of modern technologies leads to enhanced learners' outcomes, including better students' motivation, improved achievement levels, and increase interaction between student and teachers. Here, I want to finish. If there are any query, you are welcome. Any questions?
Thank you, ma'am. I would like to invite questions or discussions or inputs if any. Shall we jump to the next presenter?
Oh. Yes, ma'am, sure.
Okay. So, I would like to request Mr. Mirav Patel for the presentation and would like to request Megha, Ms. Megha and Ms. Komal to be ready for their presentation.
Good afternoon, Kavisha. I am Dr. Mirav Patel from Ganpati University, working as a professor of English and having an experience of 20 years in especially in teaching English as a second language. Before I begin, I would like to share my screen.
Yeah, by the time Mirav is sharing the screen, let me give one instruction that in case anybody has any questions regarding the presentation, you can put the question in the chat box. Those who are on the Meet, and the participants will reply in a chat box to the questions which are raised by any of the participants. Chairpersons are putting a very interesting comment, so I would request all the paper presenters to read the comments made by the chairpersons, and if possible, also respond to the comments made by the chairpersons. Dr. Kashmira Mehta and Dr. Ankita Khanna, they are the chairpersons of this particular session. Yeah, please, Meerav, continue.
Okay. Okay, I think it is visible, right?
Yes, sir.
Play the presentation. Yeah, you need to play it.
Yeah, I'm playing it.
Yeah, okay,
so,
fine.
I'm going to make presentation on the systematic process of designing pedagogy for teaching English language through an online resource. As you all know that in the present scenario, COVID-19 pandemic has challenged and compelled the world to change their teaching pedagogies to the extent that some countries who are not having enough technological advancements are facing the threat of creating a gap in their education system. As we all know that, you know, in today's situation, it has become a challenge for us to go from our offline sort of education system to an online education system. And especially in the teaching of English, the possibility of remote education is a real challenge for the teachers. Why it is a real challenge, let me tell you, because the thing is that teaching of English, more of a challenge for the people who are not very well versed with English language, and especially when you are teaching English as a second language. So taking it in a remote education, it becomes a challenge. So this has compelled them and motivated many of us to find out the solutions like teaching online or via a MOOC. However, MOOC, as you all know, massive online open courses. However, this online teaching is altogether different from offline one. So the teaching that we do online is altogether different from the teaching that we do offline. Hence, it becomes necessary for to design a paper proper pedagogy for teaching effectively online. So the pedagogy that we follow in teaching offline, in teaching English offline, may not be suitable for the same topic teaching online. So it becomes very necessary for any of the teachers to design a proper pedagogy for teaching effectively online. To design this pedagogy suitable to teach a subject like English, it is necessary that we must know how the process of and how it can be done. So if we want to design the pedagogy which is suitable for teaching a subject like English, we must know, first of all, we must all know what is the process of designing such kind of a pedagogy. So I'm going to present you a few steps. There are four steps which I have thought about is that, you know, there are four different stages or steps, you can say, which we follow to design a proper pedagogy. The first step being is the mapping and finalizing the need of the students. This means, at whatever level we want to teach English, it may be at a primary level, early primary level, secondary, higher secondary, or at a graduate or a postgraduate level. So we have to design, map the need of the students. See, what is the need of the students? Whether he wants to learn English as a proficiency language, or does he want to learn English as only for his career building? Does he want to learn English for giving certain tests? Does he want to learn English in an intermediate level? So we have to think about those things first before we start designing a pedagogy. And after mapping those needs, we have to finalize. This will help you in identifying the topic from which we can start our teaching, keeping the previous knowledge, expertise, and age group of the students in the mind. For example, here we can take an example of teaching, let's say, articles. Articles are taught in primary level of the schools, in early secondary level, and at the secondary and higher secondary level also. And even in some part of college, even the articles are taught. So when we really want to teach students articles only, we have to decide whether at what point should we start with. and what is the previous knowledge of the students, what is his expertise, and what is the age group of the students. You cannot start articles teaching like article N is used before A, E, I, O, U to a student who comes into college. So because he is very well versed with those facts very much like far back when he was in school. So we have to design certain things. We have to think about the age group. We have to think about the previous knowledge of the students. Then step two. And that step two is finding and deciding the appropriate tool. Now, as you know, that in offline, we may not need tools to design and to deliver. But in online, we definitely need tools. Tools means online platforms. Let's say, for example, this is one of the platforms. So this kind of platforms, Google Meet or whatsoever we have, we may have Playposit or we may have Prezi or we may have Camtasia, or so many tools are available online. So we have to decide, find out and decide one appropriate tool. Hello? Which can be used for teaching English. On the basis of the selected topic, and the age of the students, we must decide as to which tool will be more effective and attractive for them. For example, if you are teaching the topic to a primary level or a secondary level of students, the tool can be a little bit different. Even the fonts, even the styles of the presentation would be different. And if you are catering the students of graduate and postgraduate students at level, that means your tool will be appropriate to their understanding and learning. Accordingly, we may decide upon using the PowerPoint slides, videos, or ready-made online material like a YouTube video and all, or plain text or online lecturing method. So what method will we be using, that is also decided upon the priorly before we start teaching. Because we have to think about the age group, we have to understand about their prior background. Third is importing your ideas and expertise into the selected tool. Now, suppose I have selected my tool to be a Google Classroom or let's say Google Meet. I decided that I am going to teach, I am going to cater the undergraduate or postgrad students who are very well versed with this, this Google Meet sort of thing. So I know that this is the tool that I will be using for delivering my lectures. But then I have to import my ideas and expertise into selected tools. Every teacher is unique. Yeah, so every teacher is unique and so is the method of his or her teaching. So in order to create the effect of our uniqueness, we must import our own ideas and inputs in the selected tools to make our content more authentic and powerful. And final step is review and execution of the assessment. When the tool is designed as per our need and embedded with the expertise and uniqueness, it becomes important to review it and take a trial before its final execution. At this point, some feedback or quizzes can be included in the tool so that the teaching and learning can be made more interactive. After the trial, the tool or maybe a pedagogy is ready for execution. In conclusion, the pedagogy for teaching English online has to be designed with the help of available and created tools so as to make the teaching learning process more lucid and fruitful. Here, I have used the word pedagogy instead of the word tool because it is a unique modified structure and hence, unlike a tool, it is not fixed but can vary from a person to person. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. It was quite giving quite new strategies to us. And now I would like to request Ms. Megha and Ms. Komal for their joint presentation. Next, Mansi Gupta, please be ready.
Yes, good afternoon to all. Me and Komal, Komal and Megha has jointly researched on this paper. So we are going to present this paper through a paper presentation, or we have used this PowerPoint for that. So I will, I would like to play the PowerPoint first.
We also would request you to have social distancing and come one after another on screen.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. You're not also wearing mask when you are with somebody. So when you are in group, you have to wear mask. If you are alone, it is fine.
Yeah. Yes, yes, sure,
come,
sir.
Come one after another on camera. Huh? If you have, both of you have to speak something. Okay, please continue.
Okay. So good afternoon to all of you. The present paper is titled on emerging need of teacher training program for effective teaching through technology for the learners in remote areas. So the present research is a major try to focus on the teacher training and its emerging need in the present time. So I will start my presentation. First, as we know, the concept of online teaching, as in earlier presentation, we have discussed this, as it is a shift from a traditional classroom to online virtual classroom. And basically, I want to know, want to share the idea that the role of the teacher, it is a change from a very information inputs provider to knowledge creators. So earlier in the traditional classroom, more teaching is on information based. But now in this technical world, all the basic information, it is available online. But as we know that each and every teacher has a different understanding. So he or she can play a very important role for knowledge creators. Then, as we know that this ERT model is very a topic of discussion in recent time. As we know that this pandemic of COVID-19 has affected education system at global level. So it is a sudden emergence for teaching online, and teachers have to go online for teaching and to reach to the learners and the students. So it is an upgraded concept of technology, and it is became mandatory for each and every teachers to accept this model of teaching online. And teachers have also started, we have seen or observed that teachers have started to teach through the different technical tools, but they have start with trial and error concept. So they are trying to learn the new technical tools to reach out to the students. But what we have observed that from the 100%, the 20 and 30% teachers are well equipped with the technology and they are going well in online teaching. And 20 or 30% teachers are kind of teachers who are trying to learn by trial and errors. And 50% or 60% it's teachers are there still who are trying to teach online, but they have not proper knowledge. So there we can find the less involvement of the teachers due to the lack of proper online knowledge or knowledge of online teaching. So as a temporary access to education, we have accept this online model almost at every level of the education system. But we have observed that it is not perfectly planned and implemented like online learning that we have done earlier, because online learning was well planned by the teachers who are well equipped with educational technology. So what we have observed in this paper that we found that there is a need of teacher training. So for that, we have conducted a small survey by using a Google form, and we have shared it via WhatsApp and Facebook. And in that survey, our focus is to get views of teachers on importance of teacher training, that how to use technology properly in teaching online. So we have received responses from the diversity of the teachers, from differently located teachers in remote and urban areas both. So main objective is to know the need of teacher training and readiness of the teachers of to learn the technology and effectively can integrate it into the online teaching. So as we have seen this ERT model, and due to that, the emerging need of teacher training has arises. So in present slide, you will see the image that we have asked first to the teachers that do you think that teacher training is required in online education or not? So we find that a 93% response are very practical response, and it is positive response that 93% teachers have believed that they need teacher proper teacher training to for online education. And it is show their mental readiness to accept this online mode of teaching. They are ready to accept and ready to adapt it into the teaching. So we find that this concept of teacher training is of very capable to fill this gap between digital immigrants that we have defined as the teachers and digital natives who are the learners or the students. So this gap of skill to adopt technology very easily, that gap of the skill can be filled up with this teacher training. And it is also found that digital literacy for the teacher, it became very important 21st century skill.
Ms. Komal, yes? Will you please again share your screen, because it was interrupted.
Yes, sure. Yes, is it visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, okay. So we have also asked the teachers that if the response is positively come, that 93% teachers want teacher training. So what is the reason behind it? So these are some of the responses that we have received from the teachers. So teachers have provided some reasons that why they are in need of teacher training. So some of are mentioned here that if the teachers are well equipped with the technology, then they can prepare the next generation, that is student, for the future demands, that is also technical skills in future. And technology is a kind of new thing for most of the teachers. So it have its own complexities. So basic thing is that they require training for use this technical tools. And if they get a training, the practice that teachers are doing, so that practical involvement also sharpen the digital skills of the teachers. Then teachers are using technology in teaching and don't have, but they really don't know that how to properly use it. So we don't deny that teachers are not using. Teachers are using, but they don't know how to properly use it for effective online teaching. Then to acclimatize them with technicalities of online teaching also. And it is the need of updating skills of the teacher as a present demand. And without proper teaching or training, it can't serve the purpose of effective online teaching, which is also can be demand for the future in post-COVID-19 era. So new mode of online pedagogy, that is concept discussed earlier in the presentation. So pedagogy is also required for online teaching and training, which is not only improved the technical knowledge of the teachers regarding technology, but at the long run, it also affects the quality of teaching too. So these are some of the reasons that teachers have provided for teacher training. Next is...
You have 2 more minutes.
Yes, sure. So in present slide, you can see some of the challenges that we have also asked them, that what kind of challenges you are facing at your workplace for practicing this online teaching. So the you can see in the slide that there are some of the barriers that can create a problem in online teaching for the teachers. And we have found that 74% is more regarding in support of unavailability of latest ICT equipments. So that should be first established by the teachers and by the institute too. Then we have also provided some of the solutions that how to use technology. For that, we have to conduct a kind of workshops. So that workshop should be basic technicalities or the knowledge of basic things, how to use technology, that can be provided to the teachers. So it should be done in the regular terms, like in first SEM, in second SEM, and that can be see the development or improvement of the teachers in using technology. So that is also asked to the teachers, that what they feel that if workshops can be conducted by experts who are good in educational technology and using it into the online teaching. So if they will receive this training, how they will benefit it. So that is also you can see in the slide, present slide. So basic thing is that in today's time, you have also observed that so many webinars and conferences going on. So some of the guidance of etiquettes regarding online learning and teaching both, that is also required for the teachers. For example, setting background, dressing and other kind of etiquettes. And major focus is we have to train them that there is a difference between overuse of technology and technology as a medium. Because sometimes it's happened that teachers are being habituated by using this PPTs and other things. So if there is no electricity, teachers are hopeless or helpless that how they are teach. So use it as your medium to teach effective in the classrooms. For example, government has government of Gujarat has started this project of Namo tablets from 2017. It is given to the students, but teachers also trained to use it effectively in the classroom, which is not happening. So if it is given, it will be very effective. These are some of the suggestions that teachers has provided, that academia has different events like workshop, seminar, and that training is also given to the teachers, that how to attend it, from which platform you have to attend it, and how it will be effectively implemented in learning and teaching, both the aspects.
Ma'am, I would request you to conclude.
Yes, I'm going to conclude. I would continue, and I would try to conclude my presentation, that technophobics have no place in post-COVID academia. So the teachers who have some kind of fear to use technology, they maybe have no place in post-COVID-19 era, because we have seen the growing need of online teaching. So it should be focused on teacher training first. So in this, we have also found some of the limitation of research, that we want to focus on remote areas and the teachers who are located in remote areas. But because of the limitation of time, we have received very less number of response from rural areas. So I would like to conclude my presentation with the note that it is a need of the time that teachers should be equipped with the technology for online teaching. And it will be better through proper teacher training. So we should think of not reason, but for solution. Means not karan, but nirakaran. So thank you. I would like to conclude my presentation with this quote. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Next, I would like to request Ms. Mansi Gupta. Are you there, ma'am?
Mansi, ma'am? Yes, I'm there. Hello. Thank you so much, Kavisha, and a very good afternoon to all of you. I am Mansi Gupta from Lucknow, and first of all, I'll just like to give a small thanks to all the people who were involved in doing this seminar, that is this webinar in such circumstances, and thank you so much for making a part of it. Not taking enough time, because there are so many people who want to share their point of views, I'll directly come to the topic. I like to share my presentation first of all, so that things can go more easy. All right. So just give me a second so that I can show you my presentation. Is it visible?
Yes, ma'am.
All right.
Ma'am, I request you to run. Yes, pretty visible.
Yep. Okay, fine. I feel overwhelmed to present my views on the topic technology integrated education. That is definitely the need of our. And being a school teacher of one of the most prestigious schools, I'm working for Lucknow, and we have more than 28,000 students. And I was very easily able to connect with the topic, the real purpose for the webinar. And to make all these 28 students getting acquainted to a new technical mode of education was definitely challenging for us. It was earlier, everybody was very apprehensive about it, but soon we came out with brainstorming ideas and plans, and through which we can make our teaching reachable, convenient, and connected. So definitely we are teachers, we know how to come out with the ways. It is definitely a giant leap, I would say, as we know that the educational institutions, they were the first ones to close with the onset of COVID-19, and approximately 1.2 billion children were out of the classrooms. And since the country went into the lockdown on 25th March in the wake of COVID-19 pandemic, the management and the teachers were abruptly pushed into the uncharted online classes, which was definitely a giant leap in a country like India. In this phase of crippling pandemic, technology has emerged as a major lifesaver. And in spite of the great devastation caused by COVID, we took lockdown as an opportunity for the education sector to adapt to a digital world with maximized efficiency and accessibility. How can we keep the doors of learning open? I would like to say that COVID-19 acted as a catalyst that pushed India into expanding education system online, which kept the doors of learning open. Where it was easy for the MNCs to adopt work from home, it was quite easy for them, but at the same platform, it was very challenging for the education sector. And needless to say that the pandemic transformed the centuries old chalk talk teaching model to a one that was driven with technology. Why basically online education? This is a question that has been discussed in earlier slides, and many other people have already discussed it. I'll just give a short note for it. As far-fledged it may seem, the next 5 years may make virtual education the new norm, and the future of education will find no room to ignore the utilization of technology in an age where we are integrating technology as a way of life. And we see that the online education as a transformation, it has just given a great transformation from a teacher-centric education to the student-centric education. And we find that everything was possible through online teaching. For example, schools conducted the PTMs, the staff management meetings, and providing all the necessary interactivities, what was quite possible with the help of online education. So why not to completely rely upon the online education? So these are the upcoming challenges. As we all know it, that not all is rosy, especially when we are talking about India, where problems like lack of technology, digital training, unreliable power supply and bandwidth are the posing challenges. And the sudden shift to online learning in a country where the backbone of the online learning was not ready, still the curriculum was not designed in such format, has created a risk of students becoming passive learners and definitely were seen losing interest in a meanwhile. In the remote areas, still we are having many people, in spite I tell you this is a real situation, because I'm real person who is facing all such things. There are many people who do not own Android phones or they have gadgets. It's definitely a harsh reality to listen, but it cannot be ignored when we are transforming the country into a totally new mode. I think it became easy for us to engage our students, but we cannot expect the learning outcomes out of everything. What cannot be taught, basically, what I feel is that virtual learning surely offers a great substitute to the classroom learning in the time of this emergency, but it cannot replace the classrooms. We cannot teach discipline, the moral values, the communication skills and vocabulary through online education. That I think is very, very important part. And there are major obstacles which we are facing in our day-to-day teaching. So these are few things that I think cannot be overcome by all this. I like to conclude just by saying that what I fully wanted to be improvised in the next session after COVID, I think the future prospect is a unique blend of traditional and technical education. This online education is a potential model for a resource-crunched country like India and a personal tool for self-development. The trust and the bond between the teacher and student, it creates the perfect learning environment, and which is possible only in a classroom and cannot be achieved through the virtual learning. We need to find the resources and background of a public school combined with the flexibility and affordability of cutting edge online learning. So according to me, online and traditional, they are no two alternative paths, but they are two interwoven trails which are leading to the same destination. So we need to come up with the strategies where we can find a solution with the combination of the two. So that was what I wanted to say. Thank you so much for listening and lending your ears to me. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am. We invite questions or inputs if there are any from the participants' side. Or if there isn't any, then we shall start the next presentation. Okay, so I would request my own self, because next is my turn, and I am preparing jointly with Ms. Alpa Konda. So are you there, Ms. Alpa?
Yes, Kavish, I am here.
Okay, so we shall start.
Yes.
I'll take it.
Is the screen visible?
Yes, Kavisha, visible.
Okay.
I think it's not muted.
Sorry?
Someone's audio is not muted. Other participant has unmute their video, his or her video audio.
All right. I would request all the participants to mute their video. Audio. And please don't share the screen or present the screen, please. So we are started. Very good afternoon, everyone. This is a paper jointly prepared by Kavisha Alagya and Ms. Alpa Ponda. Focusing on the learning process, which is titled as Are We Learning? Revisiting the Learning Process by Technology Usage, Hindrances, and Improvements. So, first of all, to understand the process of learning, we shall start this presentation with understanding what is learning. So, learning is a process of acquiring skills, values, understanding knowledge, behaviors, attitudes, and preferences. So learning basically brings a change in the attitudes of the learners. Secondly, the COVID-19 crisis has allowed teachers to share knowledge via video conferencing. So platforms like Zoom, Google Meet, Skype, Cisco WebEx has provided a great opportunity to connect teachers and students in a virtual classroom rather than traditional classroom. So a learning system based on formalized teaching, but with the help of electronic resources, it is known as e-learning or online learning. The main aspect of learning from the learner's side is involvement. The complete involvement of a student makes him or her a learner. So the researchers here defines how it is used, how technology is used, what are the hindrances, and how also suggest the methods of improvements. Methodology. The researchers has employed the technique of framing questions in form of a questionnaire as a part of survey to collect data for the interpretation. There were 12 questions mentioned in the questionnaire, and as an inquiry, it was distributed or shared approximately to 300 learners. But the researchers had got 70 responses. The questionnaire was shared and distributed, dividing the survey into two aspects. As it is focusing on online learning, so technological aspects are taken into consideration, and the complete involvement from learner's side as an inquiry to the involvement, the researchers has considered the psychological aspects. Next, jumping to the technological aspects, the very first question was asked that to the respondents that have they attended online session or not, or if they had, then how many of the online sessions had they attended? So 50% of the respondents replied that they had attended up to 5 webinars. And to draw the method or the or as an inquiry to the internet connectivity, we had the researchers has also asked what kind of internet connectivity they have. So they had replied 4G internet connectivity. So obviously learners would involve themselves if the teacher is presenting. So the next question was, which kind of device are the learners using to attend webinars? So the majority of the learners had replied, 84.3% had replied mobile. They are using mobile as a device to attend webinars. The one of the advantages that mobile can be taken in hand and can be taken to wherever the learners go. So it may happen that a learner may engage in different activity or say in some kind of other activity rather than attending the class, as because if they use mobile, if they use laptop or computer, then they would create a kind of zone. So a learner always need a kind of zone environment or atmosphere for learning. But here they are using mobile, so it can be inquired to their learning process that whether they are learning actually or not. Coming to the next question, many of the learners, like 72.9% learners, are saving their data pick for the reason that they have to attend a webinar. So their main main aim of the day would be that whether they have enough data or not to attend a webinar. Like if a webinar is going or an online session is going, they would be constantly thinking whether their data would be there or it would be exhausted in between the lecture. So they would not be able to concentrate properly, or they would not get totally involved in the process of learning. Furthermore, they have some disturbances. So which are they? Like poor internet connectivity or popping notification, as their majority are using their mobiles. Additionally, unnecessary admiration and greetings of the participants in chat box, or needlessly screen shared by other participants can also avoid their learning process to get fulfilled, as well as the PPT slides heavily loaded with words. Like 71.4% of the respondents believe that due to the heavily loaded slides, they feel disconnected sometimes with the speaker. Like as you will see that if the speaker is speaking, the learner will be concentrating on the slides or reading in the content. The psychological aspects. Now, how many persons are feeling that they are totally involved? Obviously, 55. There is a dilemma from the respondent side. They are in a dilemma whether they are totally involved or not. Sometimes technological problem like video getting blurred of the speaker, needlessly screen shared by other participants, and speaker's audio gets muted sometimes. So they don't feel totally involved. Furthermore, health issues. Yes, like focusing constantly from morning to the evening on the screen can cause a visual problems or inability to focus sometimes. And yes, we had also asked that whether the materials provided by teachers on soft copies especially are sufficient. So they were in a dilemma that maybe they can satisfy their curiosity by reading online. But still, there is a need of a teacher in a classroom to make the learning process seamless. Online learning should be welcomed in the time of crisis. It's fine. And 20% of the respondents see that online learning should replace the classroom. Furthermore, technology should be welcomed in traditional classroom. That 44 of the respondents out of 70 replied that. Yes, you can also practice this. Like this slide is heavily loaded with words, and while you are concentrating to read the content, you lose the focus of what speaker is speaking. Here is the response. Like we had asked the question, write a paragraph on what you have learned from the 5 webinars which you have attended. So only 5 to 6 of the respondents were able to grasp the question and had written a good summary or expressed their knowledge of the webinars. Here is the second screen. Yes, some of the participants had created had given an amazing response that no comments or I will think upon it, or I have learned to use Zoom. Yes, basically when a learner is focusing on so much on the technical aspect that he forgets to learn what the speaker is trying to provide. So the learner focuses his attention on the technological aspects and diverting it from the content shared by the speaker. And most of them were not able to write what they have learned. It is assumed that offline forms are more easy to write, that we can write paragraphs on paragraphs on offline form. But while submitting an online feedback, then we have a very less amount of words to express. Furthermore, a suggestion was also given to us that webinars are becoming a parody of sorts. They have to be conducted by keeping in mind qualitative issues. Next, observations and limitations. As the researchers led the prior counseling, they had received a limited number of responses. 1/4 out of 300, only 1/4 response was achieved. Technological glitches affect psychology of learners. So this is the main observation of the researchers, that while focusing on so much on technological aspects, that they really forget to grasp the content shared by the speaker. And yes, questions and inputs are all obviously welcome. To conclude the presentation, here are the references. To conclude the presentation, it can be said that the researchers will further try to explore more by circulating the questionnaire once again after making it more precise for the scope of better research. They would further like to do it at the macro level to come out with more specific goal-oriented learning outcome. Thank you. Yes. Now the next presentation, Katie Priyanka. Are you there, ma'am?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, you can start your presentation, ma'am.
Okay. I'm Kati Priyanka from Department of English, pursuing MA English second year. Today's title is Practical Aspects of ELT and Technology, Outbreak of COVID-19 Pandemic. Outbreak of coronavirus disease has created a global health crisis that had a deep impact on the way we perceive our world and everyday lives. The impact of coronavirus is continued to reverberate various sectors affected and had an immense effect on educational institutions all over the world, and from the IITs to Harvard's are closed due to the lockdown. As of 24th May 2020, approximately 1.725 billion learners are currently affected. Importance of English language. English is an important language for all kinds of professional and personal goals. English is a kind of key to prosperity. It is an international language. By learning English language, acquires the four skills, that is LSOW. At present, the role and the status of English in India is higher than ever, as evidenced by its position as a key to the subject of medium of instruction. As the number of English learners is increasing, different teaching methods and have been implemented to test the effectiveness of teaching process. Use of authentic material in the form of films, radios, TVs, and has been for a long time. It is a truth that these technologies have been provided as successful in replacing the traditional teaching. The new era assigned the new challenges and duties on the modern teachers, and the tradition of English teaching has been drastically changed with the remarkable entity of technology. Technology is the most significant drives of both social and linguistic change. And the one quote from the David Gradual states that technology lies in the heart of globalization process, affecting the education, work, and culture. The use of English language has increased rapidly after 1960. At present, the role and the status of English of language of social context, political, social, cultural, business, education, industries, media, library, communication, across the boards, and a key subject in the curriculum and language of important education. Use of technology in teaching English. The use of English has increased popularity, so has to need for the qualified teachers to instruct the students in the language. However, there are the many more opportunities for the student to gain the confidence and to practice or extend themselves. The growth of ELT through technology. Technology innovations have gone in hand in hand
with the growth of English are changing the way in which we communicate, analysis on the necessity of application of multimedia technology to English language to cultivate the student interest in the study and to promote the student communication capacity, to widen the student's knowledge, to gain an insightful understanding to the Western culture, to improve the teaching effect, to improve the interaction between the teacher and the student, create the context of language teaching, to provide the flexibility of course teaching. For that, every coin has a two sides. Analyzing the problems of arising from the application of multimedia technology to the English teaching are measure means replacing by the assisting one, loss of speaking communication, and the restriction of students' thinking potential. And another thing is remote online teaching, which is a synonymous with the e-learning, takes place online. Both students and administrators interact via two-way communication technologies, and the 10 teaching strategies adapted for the remote online teaching. First thing is get to know your platform. This is so important, whether you are using completely a new system or incorporating a well-known system into your teaching. The more familiar you are with the platform, the more you are comfortable you will be, and more the professional you will give them the
Yes, Priyanka, I think you have a network problem. I think she is disconnected. Priyanka,
voice got interrupted.
Yeah, Priyanka. Priyanka, are you able to listen us? I think she is disconnected. Yeah, okay, she is there. Yes, Priyanka. Priyanka, are you there? I think, yeah. Priyanka, are you able to listen us? Priyanka? No, your voice is not audible to us. Priyanka? Priyanka, your voice is not audible to us. I think she is not able to listen. Yes, Priyanka. Yeah, Priyanka, are you able to listen? Priyanka. Constantly speaking. Okay, Kavisha, take over it now.
Okay, sir. So I invite the next presenter, Ethan Solanki. Sir, are you there?
Yes, yes, ma'am. Can you hear me?
Okay. Yes.
Okay, but someone is sharing screen.
You start sharing.
Okay.
PN Kansara is presenting this.
Yes, I have done it. Okay, is my screen visible, sir?
Your screen is visible.
Screen is visible. Shall I start? Is my PPT visible?
Start.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Good afternoon, one and all. First of all, I would like to thank Dr. Bharat for providing me this opportunity to present my views as a primary teacher of a government primary school. This is my title. Thank you very much, sir. This is the flow of my presentation. First of all, I would like to discuss the general condition of ELT in primary school, the condition of primary school, and within that, condition of English language teaching. Then there are certain challenges. I would like to focus upon that. Many online teaching tools, apps, and websites are available. I'll talk about that. Then I'll contemplate over the possible solutions, and I have certain practices. I'll focus upon that. And lastly, I'll talk about an example. I'll give an example how technology is being used in the time of a lockdown period to engage the students of primary schools. Yes, first of all, when we talk about primary schools, this kind of image comes to our mind. But since last few years, a big change has been brought, and we have development, technological development, infrastructural development, and now we have computer labs. 10 to 15 years ago, nobody could have thought even that the primary schools would have the computer labs and smart classes like Gyankun class. These Gyankun classes have made our work a little bit interesting and easy. Teaching all the subject is a little bit comfortable now in the physical classroom. But there are a few challenges of maybe persons away from the remote rural areas. These challenges might be kind of excuses, but these are the real challenges, like socioeconomic background of the parents. Almost all the parents are BPL card holder, and they cannot file. They use the simple mobile. Then even if they use a smartphone, they don't have internet access, or they have limited internet access, and they don't have they haven't actually developed a kind of approach for the education of their their kids. And that's why they do not allow their kids to use their mobile for educational purpose. If you talk about students, then students are of a little age. They are 10 to 12 years old, and they are not prone to technology the way we want them to be. I mean, they can use technology for the entertainment purpose, but they cannot use technology as we want them to do. And they are people by nature, so they have less concentration power. They cannot concentrate more than 15 minutes, I guess. Yes. Now, if you talk about online teaching English language tools, then there are several applications available, several websites available. Here, I have given some examples. This app actually teaches the student the vocabulary through pictures. So it is very easy to learn vocab words by using this app. I will skip part of the demonstration. Here we have another app that concentrate on the English reading from class 1 to class 8. Here is a demonstration how they can learn. So I mean to say, the learner can specify his speed to learn and learn reading as well as comprehension. Then I have mentioned two app here, CBC Words to help kids and TJ Key Phonics. It's all, this application actually gives the practice in learning words as well as pronunciation of the words of CBC word, that is consonant, verb, and consonant. So this kind of application helps a lot to students to learn English in proper way. But as it is observed, this kind of applications are actually made or created based on the self-directed learning model. That means the students have to use it and learn language on their own. But as we know that in primary education, that as mentioned earlier, our students, our kids are not prepared for this self-directed learning approach. So what we can do, means I will talk about now the practice, that means what we do in these situations. We use WhatsApp. Thanks to WhatsApp that it is accessible to all, and we share different files to engage our students to keep learning. Very first way is sharing PDF files. We share PDF files and give them tasks like reading task, writing task, some puzzles, and finding out spellings from that puzzles. We also give them some grammatical tests too. Students note down this in their notebook, then capture photograph and then send it to us. In this way, we engage our students using PDF files on WhatsApp. Then we also share stories in a simple English language. Here I have a demo. I would like to play it for you. Here, student just listen to the word and can have practice of reading word to word by word the sentences and paragraph. In that way, he can learn reading too. After sharing this video, let me clarify. Okay, madam. After sharing this video, we share this kind of video that is all about comprehension of the same story. Yes, this way student learn to read first word by word. They can learn spellings, and then they also learn the reading comprehension too. We also provide them some exercises through WhatsApp, through PDF files. Now, this kind of videos are very much heavy, or more than 16 MB, and we know that WhatsApp does not allow that to upload videos more than 16 MB. So what we do, we share links, and using that links, learner can learn a picture in picture kind of through picture in picture kind of a facility provided by WhatsApp. Here is a demo that when we see the send a link to the learner will simply click on the link, and he can actually have access to this kind of videos.
Sir, I request you to share your screen again. It was interrupted.
Okay, just a minute, ma'am. Is it okay now?
Okay,
is it
sir.
Okay now, madam? Okay.
Yes.
Yeah. I just finished in a minute. Yeah, I just finished in a minute. Okay, so this kind of we have already seen the video. So this way we share the video link via link through WhatsApp, and then we send this kind of you can say picture or PDF file, so that student first of all will learn the video through video, and then he will actually read from the textbook itself. Then we use the screen recorder. Earlier I have mentioned that how to use any app to teach CVC words. So here I have one example demonstration that this kind of applications means our students are not well aware of using this kind of app on phone. So what I do, I just record my screen. This is the screen of my phone, and then through sharing that video, so I share this kind of small videos to my students, and I actually provide them with some tasks. So this is how we use actually WhatsApp as a medium to engage our students during the time of lockdown. Here I have one example, Mr. Amit Prajapati, my friend. He has actually uploaded all the videos of Nanpunch classes to one platform, his YouTube channel. The link easily with all our students, and then on the daily basis he share one game with the students. Here is the demo how we share a game. It is a simple game of you can say teaching salutations. So here, using this link, actually students can learn how students are actually kept engaged with the learning process. So this is how actually we engage the students of primary schools even during the time of lockdown, as we are trained to use minimum resources and to deliver maximum. So we have actually this kind of jugaad for nowadays. I would request Dr. Barad and other participants to reflect on this and provide me with their valuable comments so that can help me in further procedure of teaching and learning online. Thank you. Thank you very much. Now it's over.
Thank you, sir. We shall continue our next presentation. The presenter is Hiren Kumar Jani. Are you there, sir?
Okay. Hello?
Yes, sir, you are audible.
Okay, hello everyone. Good afternoon. I am a techno-savvy elementary primary teacher. My school students use a lot of technology tool before Corona's time. I am grateful to Bharat sir for giving me a opportunity in this webinar. Today I will present it to you my innovation on how to learn English at home to lower level primary school and standard 4 students on this time online learning. We can use, but online learning cannot take the place of teacher, but this is also useful for this time. An effort has been made to make child digital for primary school onwards. Now I want to show my presentation.
Hiren, are you on a mobile phone or laptop?
I am on mobile phone.
Achha, no, so when you give introduction, you put your camera on, so you are visible.
Okay.
We gave these instructions in the beginning also that everybody will have to come before camera, either in the beginning or in the end, if possible, throughout the session.
Okay, sir.
Yeah, because when we are giving certificate, we have to see that the person is the same person to whom the certificate is given.
One moment, sir. My Chrome browser is not responding.
Because once you will share your screen, you won't be able to put on camera on mobile phone.
Okay, sir. Technical issue in a Chrome browser. One minute, sir.
You can come after. We will let us take one turn. You do one small rehearsal, so you can come later on. You want to take your turn after another participant?
No, I will present in mobile, sir. Laptop is a technical issue.
Okay, I think now it is visible. Now I think it is visible. Yeah.
Okay, sir. I will share my screen.
Yeah. Okay. Continue. Yeah. Continue.
Okay.
I think you are disconnected. Yeah, the presenting. Okay, fine.
My screen is visible, sir.
Yeah. Yes. Okay. Please continue. Your slides are visible.
Visible. Okay. Uh, code technology, digital textbook with QR code on standard 4, students of Sri Shahpur Primary School. I am a technology, techno service teacher, and many more techno ICT tool using my primary school. Because of my primary school in government small school, in not provided some technology school in Jnan Kunse, other some etc. tool. Myself, Hiren Kumar Ajani. I am an assistant teacher in the Shahpur Primary School in Valbipur Taluk and Bhavnagar district. And my project is digital textbook on one step for digital learning. This paper is about grassroots level village primary school student learn English to QR code technology in standard 4. My school is a very, very grassroots level school in a primary level. I am in work with many poor students, and sir, I am visible.
Yeah, please continue.
Okay, this is my school student, and they have an English textbook, and they have pasted QR codes on their own activity-wise, unit-wise, and appendix-wise activities QR codes. They created me, uploaded me, and pasted children's through my school. Standard 4 English digital textbook with QR code. This is the show of my textbook was created by me on 94 QR codes in the standard 4 English textbook.
Yes, Hiren, we are not able to listen to your voice. I think there is some network problem. No, yeah, you are not audible.
Hello, sir.
Yes. No, your voice is not audible, Hiren. I think there is some network problem on your side.
Hello, sir. I am audible.
Yes.
My screen is visible.
Yes.
Okay. We'll talk about my innovation center of the root level village. Some of two I think this textbook is by the QR code been pasted by English Standard 4. Brief detail about research paper. Bring vision school through QR code technology. During the exchange through technology in the achieving learning outcomes. Is your technology talk and talk method work with the textbook with QR code? Remove the student in 104 and to remove the of the this language.
Hiren, your voice is breaking. It is not audible. I think there is a network problem on your side. Okay, by and large, we have seen your work. It's very interesting work. Yeah, by and large, you have displayed your work there. Yeah. So let us move on to the next one. I think there is some network problem in your place where you are speaking from.
Yes, sir. Moving on to the next presenter, I would like to invite Hira Rami. Ma'am, are you there? Hira, ma'am?
Yes. Hello?
Yes, ma'am, you are audible.
Okay, fine. Before I begin this, let me present my screen.
Yes, Viral.
Yes, sir. Just give me some time. So I'm just presenting my screen.
Yeah. First, you put on your camera and then you start sharing. Because if you are on mobile, then you won't be able to do both the things together.
Sir, I have... Yes. Okay. A very good afternoon to each and everyone present over here. I'm Hira Rami, assistant professor at Galbraith University. I guess that my slide is visible and my voice is audible.
No, your slides are not visible. Your camera is off. Your camera is also off and your slides are also not visible.
No, sir, it's on. Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
Hello.
You are audible, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, your screen is not visible.
Yes, just some technical issue. Yeah.
Yes, ma'am, you can start.
Okay, just hold on. Just give me some moment.
Okay, we come back to you after one presentation. Yeah, you prepare your things by that time. Yeah. Also, yeah, let us take the next one. Hiral, you come after this one. Yeah.
Okay. So the next presenter is Guru Padya Shiv Yoginath. Are you there, sir?
No, sir, it is visible now. So let me go ahead.
I request Guru Padya Shiv Yoginath to be ready for the next presentation. Hira ma'am, you can leave and reconnect again. Till then, we can start our next presenter's presentation. Then we will join you. Ma'am?
Okay, fine. Yeah, okay.
All right. Shiv Yoginath, sir, you can start your presentation. Sir, your mic is muted. Please unmute. Sir, I request you to unmute your mic, please.
Am I audible?
Yes.
Good afternoon to all. I am Drupadaya Shivayugmat, working in Maratha Mandal Polytechnic, Karnataka, Belagavi. I teach diploma level students. I am working in Maratha Mandal Polytechnic. Now I am going to present a paper on English learning technology and English learning teaching and technology in learning process during the COVID-19. Nowadays, the English language teaching process is completely dependent upon technology in and out of the class. Some forms of technology are usually used in every language class for learning. Adapting classroom activities are imperative for teachers and students. It also encourages to develop learning process. It has become a tool for teachers to continue to grow and enhance language learning for their students. Certain recommendations for the better use of such technologies like online learning that improves the skills effectively. Further innovations in technology are also part of learning and English language teaching. The use of modern technology in teaching English is broadly understood to present with help of such a methods, use of tools, materials, devices, systems, and strategies which are directly relevant to the English language teaching and lead to the achievement of the desired goals. Thus, while technology is now generally accepted as an important educational and auxiliary tool across the range of teaching and learning contexts, it is particularly true of English language teaching, since it affords a number of potential opportunities to enhance both the content and delivery of the pedagogics typically associated with the traditional English language instruction. This is primarily achieved by enabling the student or teacher to revisit problematic content time after time until it is fully understood and assimilated. Familiarity with the concept of teaching modern technology is not merely limited to the use of modern appliances and devices, but rather obtains to the introduction of innovative systems and methods of teaching, which facilitate faster and more comprehensive learning progress. According to prevailing pedagogical theories, in utilizing the learning potential of technology, students are better able to acquire and have a knowledge and skills. The use of technology in teaching English consolidates that integrated in view of modern means system and associated with other components such as the benefits to the students by achieving the required results. The use of modern technology in English language teaching has therefore become indispensable, especially in the way of unprecedented development across numerous fields and disciplines. It is essential that education sector keep a pace of global technological revolution by adopting modern technological means such as computerization, multimedia devices, mobile phones, audio visual effects applications, and social media to optimize English language instruction and equip teachers to connect with the classroom language learners in a systematic and advanced way. The internet provides easy, immediate, and virtually unlimited access to software applications and host of auxiliary platforms and materials which can expedite English teaching and learning. While these affordances may be widely available to all, it is noted that teachers often play a key role in operating the different tools and the teaching methods. Moreover, many such programs are specifically designed to promote effective English teaching, simultaneously increasing learner understanding and attainment of English language skills. Better access of technology that provides valuable for English language learners, they are now better equipped to maintain regular independent study and see more value from their face-to-face classes with teachers and students. All in all, meaning they will be able more likely to see their courses through to completion. The digital revolution has transformed global society with the modern technology, now an integral part of our day-to-day lives. It has altered how we communicate with the other and redefined the way we consume information. Such as, it is unsurprising that the way we learn has changed forever. With the rollout of exciting new network technologies, including 4G, 5G, high altitude broadcast balloons, and possibility of global mesh of broadband delivering the satellites, the opportunity to learn will become a reality for an ever-growing number of people around the world. The ways and means of learning on technological innovation breaks down the barriers to learn language, built through making self-study more efficient, adding value to time spent in class simply through moving a language education within the reach of more people by bringing the provision of service closer to time and place of demand. Technology is supporting learning processes. Thank you. Thank you for listening.
Thank you, sir. We invite questions or inputs if there are any.
Please.
Okay, if there isn't any, then we would like to jump to our next presenter. Geeta Sharma ma'am, are you there? Hiral ma'am is there. Ma'am, would you like to present your paper?
Yes, ma'am.
All right, ma'am. You can start now.
Okay. Is my screen is visible?
No, ma'am.
Okay, just.
Yeah. Are you there, Hiral?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay. Yeah.
I would request Geeta ma'am to be ready.
Sir, can I present my PPT through my mobile? Because through the laptop it's being not.
Yes, you can. You can present, yeah.
Yeah, thank you. Just give me some time.
since there is some problem on your side, Hiral.
Yes, sir. Sir, I'm just doing.
Sir, it's like a class is waiting for a teacher, and there is lot of hullabaloo in the classroom.
Okay. I think now it is being visible.
Yes. Yeah.
So very good afternoon to each and everyone present over here. I'm Hiral Rani,
you have to rotate your mobile phone.
Okay.
Because it won't be visible full screen if you do not rotate your mobile phone.
Oh, okay, just wait. Okay, fine, sir. Hello.
But. Still, I think you have to check that feature of portrait and rotate in your mobile phone.
Sir, I have done.
Okay. Now it is done. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Please continue now. Yeah.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Okay. So today. So today I'm going to present a paper on a comparative study of online versus offline English language learning. So in which I will talk about the needs of the English language learning throughout the world, and also I will brief out of what is offline and online learning. And then after I will touch upon online versus offline and pros and cons. So moving ahead. So in this slide, the needs of the English language learning. So first is that English may not be the most spoken language in the world, but it is the official language of 53 countries and spoken by around 400 million people across the globe. So being able to speak English is not just about being able to communicate with the native English speaker. So it is the most common second language in the world. If you want to speak to someone from another country, then the chances are that you will both be speaking English to do this. So British Council projects that by 2020, 2 billion people in the world will be studying English. The second one is that English is the dominant business language, and it has become almost a necessity for people to speak English if they are to enter a global workforce. So research from all over the world shows that cross-border business communication is most often conducted in English. And many international companies also expect that employees to be fluent in English. The third is that many of the world's top films, books, and music are published and produced in English. So therefore, by learning English, you will have access to great wealth of entertainment and will be able to have a greater cultural understanding. If you speak English, then you will not need to depend on translation and subtitles anymore to enjoy your favorite books, songs, films, or television shows. And last one is that, according to the report by Education First, English is the language of the internet. So an estimated 52% of the world's most visited websites are displayed in the English language. So learning in English is the important, as it gives us access to over half the content on the internet. Okay. Next, in this slide, I will just will touch upon this, what is offline learning. So offline learning is also known as the back to basic, then conventional education or customary education. So refer to the long established customs that society traditionally used in schools, colleges. And classroom learning has students and teachers know each other in a better manner. This also allows teacher to know the students and evaluate their strengths and weaknesses better. So act as a mentor and guide students in their career possibilities. Here, John Dewey, who was an educational reformer, who described as being imposed from above and from outside, the students are expected to obediently receive and believe these fixed answers. And teachers are the instrument by which this knowledge is communicated and these standards of behavior are enforced. In the next slide, I will talk about what is online learning.
as we all know that online learning is the education that takes place over the internet. It is often referred to as e-learning, among other terms. So however, online learning is just one type of distance learning, the umbrella term for any learning that takes place across the distance and not in a traditional classroom. So distance learning has a long history and there are several types available today. Online learning is catalyzing a pedagogical shift in how we teach and learn. There is a shift away from top-down lecturing and passive students to a more interactive, collaborative approach in which students and teachers co-create the learning process. The teacher's role is changing from the sage on the stage to the guide on the side. So in this slide, I will talk about the online versus offline. The first fundamental difference among the online and offline learning is the location. With the offline learning, faculties and students are required to make a trip to the learning area, normally at colleges, schools, or study halls. But with the online learning, then again, the homeroom can be the lead from all intents and purposes, any place on the planet, as we are doing right now. Another I think someone has presented their screen.
Ma'am, I need you to present your screen again.
Okay, fine. I think it's visible. Hello?
Yes, ma'am, it is.
Okay, so in the first fundamental, I have discussed about this location. It is a very difference between our online and offline. The second one is that adaptability advertise. So web-based adapting generally has an increasingly adaptable time scales as a staff, and they can offer their help by means of email or through an online talk framework. But with the offline learning, it is simply done with the school hours and doesn't offer as much adaptability to schools or to staff. So in the next slide, I will discuss about the offline pros and cons. So talking about the pros, so there is a process of learning is not isolated. So there is a teacher present at all times to answer the students' queries. And any doubts and problems can be solved immediately. And simultaneously, the learning is very high as there are other students learning along and sharing knowledge. And also individual content can be also like increased. But however, in our traditional classes are more suitable for young children, teenagers who are yet to join the workforces. Because regular attendance in the classes help them interact with the other individuals of their own ages, be better disciplined, follow a regular schedule, and improve their physical fitness and mental alertness. On the other hand, there are the travel expenses, accommodations, so on, must be taken care of.
Ma'am, you have 2 more minutes.
Yes. So if the students head from these places where there is no schools and educational institutes, in this control, online exercise we obviously are a long ways ahead. It is not completely independent way of learning, but students tend to be a very dependent on the teacher for every details. In the next slide, I will talk about these pros and cons of the online classes. So first is that the living expenses, the travel expenses, adjustment to new culture, moving away from home and family, etc., can be avoided in the online classes.
The second one is that the classes can be attended to any at any place or at any time as per the student's choice. And there is no other students out there to disturb the class. So uninterrupted learning can be achieved. And the materials can be also stored and used for a long time. Some especially videos containing lectures come with the options of downloading and reviewing. So if there is a doubt, the same can be repeated several times without actually annoying any teachers as such. But even those who are working during the daytime can also opt for distance learning and educate themselves. While on other hand, in cons, one has to have an access to the internet. Backup of a power supply is must. Otherwise, important updates can be missed out. If there is an issue with the subject or anything else, immediate aid cannot be assured. So as it is online, a query sent will be answered only if there is someone online on the other end. If not, the student has to wait until a response comes back. So there is no interactions with others, and also it's being isolated from form of learning. So these are some references from which I have just made my PPT. And here you can also see that I have done one small survey of my students of Ganpat University during this COVID-19 pandemic. Here you can see the feedbacks from the students, mostly students have put their understanding on both modes, offline and online, and they have approached both modes. But mostly they have found online learning is more convenient, more feasible, and through the online learning is being more accessible. So here I would like to conclude my PPT with the quote of, online learning is not the next big thing, but it is now big thing. So a very...
Yes, ma'am. Okay, so thank you, Hiral ma'am. Now I would like to request Geeta Sharma ma'am to present her research. Geeta ma'am, are you there? Geeta ma'am?
Hello.
Okay, so the next presenter is Garima Tiwari, ma'am. Are you there, ma'am?
Yes, hello.
Yes, ma'am, you are audible.
Yes. Shall I start presenting?
Yes, ma'am.
Is this visible, my PowerPoint?
No, ma'am, it's not.
Okay. Is it visible now? I hope it's visible.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, it is.
Okay. Namaste. Good evening, ma'am. Everyone.
I'm sorry to interrupt you, but I request you to run your PPT, please.
Okay. I'll do it. Yes. Yeah. Namaste. Good evening, everyone. I'm Garima Tiwari, research scholar, Department of English, the Maharaja Sayaji Rao University of Baroda. I'm going to present my paper titled Technology Enabled English Language Teaching. Here I'll be talking about English as a second language. I would like to thank the organizer of the webinar to give me this opportunity. This research paper includes various innovative practices in teaching English as a second language to non-native speakers. India is a country where English is a language of immense importance. English has become very much part of our life as the world has become a global village due to technological advancements. India is a country of diversity, which is very much visible in the context of languages. In such a multilingual country, English is a second language to an Indian, where it is very it is very common to have familiarity to more than one languages. In this scenario, the biggest challenge lies in teaching English as a second language to non-native students or learners. The learners will be able to learn any Indian language easily. But at the same time, learning English is a challenge for them. Have you ever thought of this? Why does this happen only in the context of English as a language? Why does this happen to mostly of the learners? Yes, the acquisition theory is one of the reasons, but not only reason, and even not the major one. The biggest reason behind this is a fear of speaking, being judged by others, lack of vocabulary, unawareness of grammar, etc. The learners don't have fear of all this while learning other Indian languages. There are a few challenges that the students face, as I have already discussed. Objectives of this particular study to find out the problem among non-native learners of English language, to suggest a few new technology-enabled online ways of teaching English as a language, to make the classroom interactive, to make education skill-based rather than knowledge, to teach practically rather than theoretically. As we know that English language teaching is booming, and a lot of researchers and scholars have written their scholarly articles as well as books, which I have gone through. For this particular research, I have used methodology that is qualitative, exploratory, descriptive, and at times comparative. This paper is more of my experience with my students, and what I feel that rather than teaching students grammar or teaching them through grammar translation methods, rather than judge them, or they should not feel that anybody is judging them. We should bring our classroom in a direction where it is practice oriented. Students are applying something, or they are using the knowledge, or like the classroom is basically practical lab rather than a classroom where teacher is teaching. Teacher should be a facilitator, and the students are doing various activities. What I would like to say is there are various applications available, and mostly of the students are using applications. The thing is, we need to mold them in the direction where they can learn English from this application, which they are using on the regular basis. On an average, students are spending like 5 hours of their time of a day on various applications. So if we are going to mold them, they'll be able to learn English from the various applications. First thing is Instagram. Recently, Instagram has come up with gibberish. If we just can challenge our students to solve that gibberish, even through that, they can learn English. On YouTube, when each and every teacher is teaching them on board, chalk the a few videos be able to learn English. You all must be wondering that why TikTok is here. TikTok is an application, a lot of controversy is going on, but through there are good content creators, and they are putting up videos on English language. By watching those videos, students will be able to various applications like Grammarly, translations, dictionary, through which they can also improve their English. We can mold the students to gamification. Kahoot is an application through which you can bring your students to games. Various movies, like for example, English movie with Hindi subtitle or Hindi movie with English subtitle, can teach our students English. Series, booming in today's world. Students are continuously watching series on Netflix Voot, Amazon Prime, and whatnot. It is giving enabled feature of subtitles, which can be used by students to learn English. At the same time, you can ask your students to do certain activities of creating videos, as we all know that writing and speaking are two active skills. We can ask our students to focus on that, and by using this particular idea of active skills, we can ask students to create videos. In that, they will get conscious and they can come up with learning of English. Results and implications. I have been practicing this in the class to teach English language. These innovative practices are very much helpful in real as well as virtual classrooms. This will bring an active classrooms. Students will enjoy learning English language, and it is going to be student-centric classroom in which teacher will be there as a facilitator. And what are the applications which are available in their mobile phones, they'll be able to learn it. A few references, and thank you. Hello.
Yes, thank you, ma'am.
Yes.
For sharing your insights. Now I would request Geeta Sharma, ma'am. Are you there now? Is Geeta ma'am there?
Yeah, I think she is absent here.
Okay.
Yeah, she is the only one not presenting in this part, or is, was there anybody else?
No, sir. She is the only one.
She is the only one. Okay. Okay.
Am I audible, sir?
Avisha, for,
am I audible, sir?
Wonderful anchoring of this session. Now I would like to request our chairpersons to give their final remarks within 5 minutes. Each of you. So may I request Kashmira madam first to give your opinion about this session and the paper presentations. Kashmira madam.
Yes, sir. Good afternoon, sir. I was looking for a rewarding experience, and yes, it was rewarding experience to be with you and the paper presenters who were present in this international webinar. The subject was quite interesting for me, that you have to give a practical strategies for remote teaching. And various participants have presented their papers and given their insights into that. And I could make out 5 points out of that, and which I am just sharing it with you within 5 minutes as I have to. So first one is establish your presence. If you are there online, you have to establish your presence, whether on YouTube or whatever medium you are choosing. Number two is you have to be available, not only physically, but online also. So that is number two. So number one, establish your presence. Number two, be available. Number three, use online resources. Now, in the last lecture, you have used poll. That was very interesting, Dr. Bharat. So you have to all the resources when you are using it online. And the fourth one is don't lecture only. To make your presentation interesting, you have to go for presentations, videos, audios. There are a lot many things available online. And the fifth one and the last one that I would like to suggest is provide ongoing feedback. And that is very interesting. When you unmute your mic in between and you interrupt, like a student's comment or a teacher's comment, or you just answer the comments that are in the ongoing schedule, it makes it very interesting and lively. So these are the 5 things I would like to add in your practical strategies for remote teaching. And thank you very much for having me here. Thank you very much, sir. It was a rewarding experience.
Thanks a lot. It was wonderful. Very good points. Very practical points. Yeah.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah. Now I would like to request Dr. Ankita Khanna for her opinion and her final comments.
Okay. Good afternoon, everyone. Once again,
It was really an enriching experience to be a part of this entire event. I listened to many papers, all of them very, very well researched and beautiful articulation, beautiful presentation. So congratulations to all the participants here. Very nice presentations. So very quickly, I would like to sum up what I have to say in this regard when we are talking about English language teaching and technology. Number one, adding to what Kashmira ma'am already said, that the most difficult thing in online teaching is to retain the learner's interest. We never know that when they are with us and when we have lost them, right? So we need to design, develop some strategies so that we are aware of the learner's, you know, presence with us, even in the Zoom classroom or Google Meet. Second thing that I have to say is that it is, though it sounds a little difficult, but we can make some efforts to make our learners physically active, even in the online sessions. We can design some games like Treasure Hunt or something for them where they are allowed to just get up from their seats and move around their house for a while and maybe then get back to their places. Because sitting online for 4 hours in front of the screen, it also causes screen fatigue. So it becomes a very, very, you know, monotonous for the students. We can make use of technology in a lot of ways. For instance, we have breakout rooms in the Zoom platform where we can actually divide the students into groups like we do in the physical classroom, right? So there are so many things that we were actually doing in the physical classroom and we can do on the online platforms also. I have many things to say, but I understand that we have limited time, so I will not take much of time, but I just want to conclude by saying that this is a time that will pass and we will go back to the classes, we will interact with the students. But blended learning is here to stay, where a combination of face-to-face learning and online learning will always be there. So with this, I end my talk and thank you, everyone.
Thanks a lot, Dr. Ankita Khanna. Thanks a lot. It was a wonderful final remarks. So on behalf of Department of English, our university, Maharaja Krishna Kumar Sinji Bhavnagar University, I'm very thankful to both the chairpersons for giving their time and giving their wonderful final remarks. Thanks to Kavisha also for handling the entire event here. Thank you all the paper presenters for your good work and wonderful presentations. We take a break of 10 minutes now and we are moving towards the fourth and the final paper presentation session of today. So after 10 minutes, we are meeting again here for the final presentation session today. Thank you all of you. Thanks.